Hi, I'm Kevin. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to do a gear review of the Goal Zero Venture 30 solar kit with the Nomad 7 Plus solar panel. Hi, I'm Kevin. I'm a YouTuber and I make a lot of videos about backcountry travel. And when I'm in the backcountry, I have substantial power needs to supply all my cameras. I bring a ton of extra batteries. I find that's the most cost-effective and lightest way is to bring extra batteries. So that's, these are for my DSLR, which I'm shooting with right now. This is what I bring to shoot my small Fuji action cameras. There's a few more here. I bring a few batteries for the GoPro. I also use a drone quite a bit, so I need to power the controller for that drone and the cell phone that plugs into the controller. So I have substantial power needs on the trip. I find that when temperatures get cold, some of these batteries will only last 5 or 10 minutes, especially if I'm operating at around freezing or below freezing. These do not last very long, and so I need to replenish that power. Plus, these controllers don't have batteries. They have an internal battery, which I need to charge directly. So I thought I would go get myself a solar power kit and try one out. Before buying this product, I read numerous reviews, and I've got to say the Venture 30 solar kit has some very mixed reviews out there. Some folks have had a great experience with this product, and others certainly have not. After using the Venture 30 solar kit, I can now explain the causes of most of those negative experiences, and I can share some insights on how to address them. I'll get to that later. Let's start by taking a closer look at this device. This system consists of a solar panel, which is the Nomad 7 Plus, and the Venture 30 battery pack. Both components can be bought separately, but they are often sold as a complete system. Goal Zero makes the claim that this is weatherproof, and so you should be able to use it on a rainy day, but I wouldn't recommend submerging the product. In full sunlight, the Nomad 7 can produce 7 watts of power and be used to charge the Venture 30, which has a full capacity of 7800 milliamp hours. I'll put detailed weights and dimensions of this system below, but the overall weight of the system is 732 grams or 1.98 ounces. The Venture 30 on its own is only 253 grams. It's a little larger than a deck of playing cards, and it has two 2.4 amp USB ports and one micro USB port. It has a power meter. You push the button right here, and it has 5 LEDs that tell you how full the pack is. It also has 5 white LEDs that can be used as a flashlight. The Venture 30 does not require the solar panel. You can charge this up at home and simply bring the Venture 30 along fully charged if you wish. On the Venture 30, there's a detachable power cord that connects from the micro USB port to the Nomad 7 Plus solar panel. The Nomad 7 is 478 grams or just over 1 pound. There's a pocket on the back which holds the charging cord. This pocket doubles as a kickstand for the solar panel and helps you point the panel towards the sun. This pocket is removable, and if you're a backpacking gram counter, then that just removed 25% of the weight of the solar panel. The Nomad 7 Plus folds in half and is held closed by magnets. The kickstand is also held closed by magnets, but soon after purchasing this product, two of the magnets on the top came unglued from the solar panel. I was a little disappointed. It's not a big deal, but I did think it should last more than a week. This also comes with a couple of little carabiners to help you attach it to something like a backpack. This Plus version of the Nomad 7 is advertised to have a smart technology that recognizes when a battery is full and it stops charging. It also knows the difference between a full battery and one that disconnects because of a lack of sun. When the sun returns, it restarts and continues charging. Goal Zero describes this as an advantage over other brands. So what triggered my purchase of a Goal Zero Venture 30 solar kit was the fact that this system is interchangeable with other Goal Zero products. Goal Zero makes both larger versions of the battery pack and the solar panel. Goal Zero makes a number of sizes of battery packs. The next size up is the Venture 70, which is more than double the capacity of the Venture 30. And they also make a Nomad 14 solar panel, which is double the charging capacity of this Nomad 7. I decided that if after using the Venture 30 solar kit, I felt like I needed more charging or more storage capacity, I could easily upgrade one or both components. Also, Goal Zero products are fairly easy to find, and if for some reason I need to replace something on short notice right before a trip, there's a good chance I'll be able to go and find it in the local store. You do pay a little bit more for the brand recognition and convenience, as Goal Zero products tend to be a little pricier than other options. The Goal Zero website indicates that the Venture 30 solar kit should charge in 8 to 16 hours of full sun, and that when plugged into a USB source, it will charge in about 5 hours. When I first got this solar kit, it was midwinter, and you're not supposed to use this in freezing temperatures. So what I did to test it out was I propped it up in my window and pointed it towards the low angle sun and left it there for the day while I went to work. I found that in those less than ideal conditions, the Venture 30 charged in about 2 days. So that's about 16 hours. I brought this solar kit on a recent canoe trip, and under optimal conditions, I was getting a full charge in about 6 or 7 hours. That's much quicker than what Goal Zero advertises, and it's probably not possible if the specifications are right, but that was my experience. It charged very fast when I had perfect conditions. It's important to remember that anytime the conditions are not perfect, that the performance drops off very quickly. Any little bit of cloud, shade, or if the solar panel isn't pointed directly at the sun, you're going to see reduced performance. On the charging cord, there are 4 little LED indicators that give an indication of the amount of power that the solar panel is being produced. The panel can be used to charge electronic devices directly, but I recommend first charging into the Venture 30, and then if you want to charge other devices, plug them into the USB ports here. This gets to one of the very common complaints that I've seen in online reviews. Many folks have complained that their cell phones will not work with the Nomad 7 Plus. What I've learned by doing some research is that many cell phones require a full 7 watts of power before they accept a charge. So many cell phones can only be charged directly by the Nomad 7 under perfect sunlight conditions. The Venture 30 battery pack is able to provide the necessary 7 watts of power to a cell phone, so phones can be charged with the battery pack. And if it's plugged into the solar panel, this will continue to trickle charge even if conditions are not optimal. You can also charge more than one device at a time this way. Something else that I experienced and saw in many of the negative reviews online was that the connection between the Venture 30 and the Nomad 7 needs to be secure. If they aren't connected properly, the LEDs on the Nomad 7 will still light up and give you the impression that everything's working fine, but the Venture 30 will not be getting the power. This happened to me once, and now that I know what the issue is, it's easily addressed just by making sure that you have a proper connection. Now, all phones have different battery capacities. Mine has a 3000 milliamp hour battery, and I was able to charge this twice from 0 to 100% with the Venture 30. Before going on this trip, I wasn't sure if the Venture 30 power kit would provide enough power for my needs, but the system worked great for me. I was able to manage my battery inventory and have plenty of power on an 8-night trip, and I was able to power my travel partner's phone as he was using it frequently to play music and take pictures. The other very common complaint I saw in reviews about this product was that the Venture 30 solar kit does not work well on a backpack. Goal Zero does promote this kind of use in its advertising, but despite the advertising, you have to remember that an 8-hour charge time is only really possible under optimal conditions. Cloud, shade, or a bad angle of the solar panel to the sun will all cause a sharp decline in performance. On a canoe trip, I was able to get a decent charge while traveling by mounting the Nomad 7 on top of our gear in the canoe. But by far, the best charging occurred in a stationary open area where I could position the panel directly at the sun. If you want to use this on a backpacking trip, I would recommend not relying on travel time as charge time. If I ever use this on a backpacking trip, I'm going to plan on using it in camp in a shade-free location. So overall, I'm very happy with the Goal Zero Venture 30 solar kit with the Nomad 7 Plus panel. It certainly has a few quirks, but when used properly, it was just right for my needs. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please like the video and consider subscribing to my channel. If you do subscribe, also hit that notification button so you get notifications when I post a new video. Thanks for watching. All the best, guys.